Length of the Seasons. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory.
I'll bet that most of you are under the impression that the four seasons are equal in length, when in fact none of them are the same number of days and nights long. So which season is the longest and which is the shortest?
Well, I'd bet most school children would say that summer is the shortest because it seems to just fly by. But is that true, or is it simply a matter of human perception? Let's find out.
Okay, now everyone knows that our Earth makes one trip around the sun once a year. In fact, astronomically speaking, that's exactly what a year is, the amount of time it takes for any planet to make one trip around the sun. And one Earth trip is 365 and a quarter Earth days long.
Now, according to Kepler's laws of planetary motion, the closer a planet is to the sun, the faster it will travel. The farther it is from the sun, the slower it will travel. So, because our Earth's orbit is not a perfect circle, but is a slightly stretched out circle called an ellipse, and since our sun is not at the center of this ellipse, our Earth actually varies its distance from the sun during the year. When it's closest to the sun, it travels fastest, and when it's farthest, it travels slowest.
Now, believe it or not, our Earth is actually closest to the sun in January and farthest in July. So our Earth actually travels faster when it's winter in the northern hemisphere and slower during the summer. Let's show you. Okay, on the first day of spring, our Earth is traveling at a speed of 66,900 miles per hour. It is actually moving farther from the sun and slowing down, and thus takes 93 days to go from the first day of spring to the first day of summer. So spring is 93 days long. Then the Earth continues to slow down until it's at its furthest point from the sun, the first week of July, when it reaches its slowest speed of 65,500 miles per hour.
Thereafter, because it's starting to move back closer to the sun, it slowly starts to speed up. Even so, it takes 94 days for our Earth to travel from the first day of summer to the first day of fall, which makes summer 94 days long. Then, as it moves closer and closer to the sun, it picks up more speed day by day, so that it takes only 90 days to travel from the first day of fall to the first day of winter. Thus, fall is 90 days long.
And our Earth continues to speed up until it reaches its closest point to the sun the first week of January, zipping along at 67,600 miles per hour, which is 2,200 miles per hour faster than its speed in July. In fact, it only takes 89 days for our Earth to go from the first day of winter to the first day of spring.
So even though summer feels like the shortest season to any school kid, winter is actually 5 days shorter and is the shortest season of the year for the northern hemisphere, and summer is the longest.
Shifting gears a little bit, let's see what the planets are doing next week.
Okay, we have our skies set up for any night this week, about an hour after sunset, facing southwest. High in the sky, you'll see the dazzlingly bright planet Venus. And just above it and to the left is the red planet Mars. Both planets are between the constellations of Aquarius, the water bearer, and Pisces, the fish.
And for you early morning planet watchers, about an hour before sunrise, you can see Mercury and Saturn near the southeastern horizon. And you can see the giant planet Jupiter high in the sky, almost due south.
And if you go outside before sunrise near the end of this week, you'll see the moon pass near Jupiter on January 19th, near Saturn on the 24th, and near Mercury on the 25th.
So enjoy the shortest season of the year as you
keep looking up.